Hi guys, good evening, welcome. Hi Jonathan, nice to see you.
Hi, good evening.
Hello Saira, welcome. How was your day at work? Did you have a good day? Yes. Okay, Lily, there you are, your beautiful backgrounds. And do you have one for the role play? Ya tiene el del role play, Lily.
Good evening.
Hi, Saira. Nice to see you.
Hi, teacher.
Welcome. We missed you yesterday. You and Jonathan didn't come.
Thank you.
But now you're here. Okay. I'm going to take the attendance, okay? And then we can move forward. Okay. And now the list has changed. So now it's back to normal. We start with Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
First one now. And then Ana Lilia.
Present.
Okay. Present, Brian, teacher.
Thank you. Brian.
Present.
Thank you, Brian. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Okay. Francisca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jose Arnoldo. Jose Galileo. Jose Jonathan. Then,
present.
Okay, thank you. Then Jose Rodrigo, Juan Carlos, Laura Carolina, you already said present. Uh-huh. Maria Concepcion.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Then Maria Elena.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, then Mayra Moreno. Nelson. Nelson Merino.
Teacher, present.
Okay. No he llegado todavía a su nombre, but okay, thank you. Ahorita le agrego. Oscar Villatoro. Oscar. Ah, okay, Oscar, yeah. Zaira. Zaira Larín.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Wendy Zabaleta, ya dijo presente. And Jenny Santos. Okay, Jenny's not here yet. Okay, so today we will start the class by practicing a tongue twister. The tongue twister I have is to practice the S. That is what we will be practicing, the S sound, right? So you have to say this three times fast. Okay, and remember what we mentioned yesterday. We have to try to make the right sound when it comes to the S. So it says, six sticky skeletons, six sticky skeletons, six sticky skeletons. That is all you have to say, sticky skeletons. Remember, no E in front or first, just the S. Okay. And we will start with Ana. Okay, Ana, you're going to be the first one. You have to say it fast, okay? And remember the S sound. Trate de recordar el sonido que estamos practicando, Ana, de la S, ¿verdad? Sin la E, sin ponerle una E al principio.
Chicken, skeletons.
Skeletons.
Skeleton.
Un poco más pronunciada, Ana. Skeleton.
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 Y es al final pronunciada, Tisha.
Mm-hmm. Yes, skeleton.
Skeleton. Skeleton.
Okay. Pero la S del principio no la escucho, Ana. Would you say it again?
Skeleton. Skeleton.
Uh-huh. Skeleton.
Skeleton.
Can you say it again?
Mm-hmm. Six. Six. A sticky mm-hmm. skeleton.
Mm-hmm. Okay, two more times. Dos veces más, two more times.
Six sticky skeletons.
Mm-hmm.
Six, a sticky skeleton.
Yes, there you go. Thank you, Ana. Now, Lily, now it's your turn.
Skeleton.
Okay, again. One more time.
Skeleton.
Sticky.
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 Skeleton.
Ajá. Yes. Okay, Lily. Thank you. Now let's listen to Wendy.
Sticks, sticking skeletons.
Mm-hmm.
Sticks, sticky skeletons.
Uh-huh.
Sticks, sticky skeletons.
Correct. Thank you, Wendy. Zaira, could you please continue?
Stick, sticky skeletons.
Mm-hmm.
Six sticky skeletons.
Yes. One more time.
Six sticky skeletons.
Uh-huh. Good pronunciation. Thank you, Zaira. Now, Oscar, could you continue? Are you there, Oscar?
Yes, I got my microphone.
Ah, okay. Could you say that, please? Three times.
Sick, sticky skeleton. Sick, sticky skeleton. Sick, sticky skeleton.
Thank you, Oscar. Can you say this one again? Six.
Sick, sticky skeleton.
Okay, thank you, Oscar. Then Mayra. Okay, Mayra, continue, please.
Six stick skeleton. Six stick skeletons.
One more time.
Me falta una.
Ajá, yes.
Stick skeletons.
Thank you, good job. Just this one here will be sticky. That will
sticky.
Be the, ajá, sticky. Thank you, Mayra. Now, Brian. Would you continue, please?
Six sticky skeletons.
Mm-hmm.
Six sticky skeletons. Six sticky skeletons.
Thank you. Good job, Brian. Okay, this is tongue twister number two. Okay, this is to pronounce or to practice this sound. It sounds it. So it says, no need to light a night, light on a light night, like tonight. Okay, this is the pronunciation. I-G-H-T sounds it. No need to light a night, light on a light night, like tonight. Okay, so we will start with Carlos. Okay, Carlos, you're the first one.
No need to light a nightlight on the light night, light tonight.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Thank you. That's only once. Ellie, are you there, Ellie?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Ellie. It's your turn.
Yes. No need to light a nightlight on a light night, like tonight.
Mm-hmm. Good pronunciation. Then Galileo, can you continue, Galileo, please?
Yes, ma'am. Good evening.
Good evening.
No need to light a night light on a light night like tonight.
Correct. Uh-huh. Good pronunciation. Now, Jonathan, it's your turn.
No need to light a night light on a light night like tonight.
Yes, uh-huh. Good job. Then Laura, can you please continue?
No need to light a night light on a light night like tonight.
Yes, okay, correct. Good pronunciation. Maria Concepcion.
No need to light a night light on a light night like tonight.
Yes. Thank you, Maria Concepcion. Elena, can you continue?
Yes.
No need to light. Excuse me. No need to light a night. Mm-hmm. A night light, night light, night.
One more time, Elena, please.
No need to light a night light on light night light night.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay. Thank you, Maria Elena. Then, hi, Arnoldo. Can you please repeat? Can you say the tongue twister?
No need to light a light. No need to light a night light on a light night light tonight.
Yes. Thank you, Arnoldo. And you're Nelson, welcome. Are you here, Nelson? No, no, not yet. Okay. All right. So let's continue. I'm going to share with you more vocabulary. I will share something here for you to see it that contains vocabulary about restaurants. Okay. If you have questions, please let me know. Okay. So this is vocabulary we can use when it comes to restaurants. Okay, so we start with booking. That's the first one we have here. Okay, Mayra, can you read point number one? Booking, please.
Booking an arrangement made with a restaurant in advance to eat there a particular time.
Thank you. In simple words, remember that is about reserving, right? Reserving a place. That's to book, to reserve a place in the restaurant. That's booking. I want to book a table for tonight, to book. And here you have the definition in English. But remember, it's a verb. We use it as a verb. Now, look at number two, a party. So this is not a party like the normal parties. This is something different. Okay, could you read that one, Omar, please? Are you here, Omar? No, he's not here yet, right? Okay, Oscar, can you read point number two, please?
A party, a group of people who arrange to eat together.
Uh-huh. So a party is a group of people. There is a party of five. A party of five is the same as a group of five. Okay, that is what you're saying when it comes to restaurants. The waiter can say, how many people is with you? Okay, it is a party of seven. Okay, you are trying to say that it's a group of seven people. Do you understand me? The word party? Yes? Okay. Next, here you have an example. We have an example using book and using party. Can you read the example, Anna, please? Using those two points.
Example and the sentence. I would like to book a table for party. All five, please can you first who's in a 7 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. In other words, you are saying, I would like to reserve, right? I would like to reserve a table for a group of five, please. I want to be there at 7 o'clock. Okay, can we be there at 7 o'clock? Okay, so it's another option. Es lo mismo, ¿verdad?, que las palabras que les pongo ahí, pero es la más popular cuando se habla de restaurantes, ¿ok? Que sería book or party, ¿ok? Así que party puede tomar otros significados, pero depende del contexto. También puede ser un partido político, party, depende de cómo lo usen. Okay, next one. Can you help us with that one, Elena? Menu.
Yes. Menu, a printed list of meals that a restaurant reserves.
Mm-hmm. So menu, I think we're okay with that one, right? With the menu. I think we're fine. So let's continue with the next one. Drinks menu. Jonathan, can you read the information, please?
Sorry, where?
Drinks menu.
Drink menu. A list of soft drink and alcoholic drink that you can choose from. Some restaurant may also have a wine menu.
Thank you, Jonathan. Good pronunciation. Only this one in English is alcoholic.
Alcoholic.
Uh-huh. Alcoholic drinks.
Alcoholic.
Mm-hmm. What is your favorite alcoholic drink, Jonathan? Wine, whiskey, beer?
Wine.
But wine. Red yes. Wine. Oh, okay. That's nice. It's a good selection. And Zaira, what about you? What is your favorite alcoholic drink? Mojitos, margaritas. What is your favorite alcoholic drink? Zaira. Zaira, I'm sorry. I meant to say Zaira.
Margarita drink.
Margaritas. Uh-huh. They are
margarita.
Thank you, Zaira. So that's about the drinks menu. Okay, yesterday we studied the word specialty, right? Here you have other two options. You can call it today's special or specials. So you have like three options. Laura, can you read the definition, please?
Okay. Today's specials. Extra dishes, cook on the day, with mm-hmm. which are not on the main menu.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Laura, do you know one restaurant that offers specials? Do you know one restaurant that has this offer, specialties for the day?
Cuando es buffet, Chinese food.
Uh-huh. They have specials. I was thinking about Subway. I don't know if you like to eat there at Subway. They usually have this. Every day you go, they have a specialty. Each day.
Un día especial, o sea, un plato especial en X día, teacher.
Ajá, that is the special, today's special.
En Wednesday, Subway is meal, creo, no me recuerdo cuál es el especial de ese día.
Neither do I. Ajá, but they have that, right? They have a special dish for each day. Mm-hmm. Those are called specials. Okay, all right. Thank you, Laura. Next one. Galileo, can you read the next one? Cutlery.
Yes, ma'am. Cutlery. Knives, forks, and spoons.
Uh-huh. Thank you. So when you have those three things, you have knives, you have forks, and spoons, that is called cutlery. Do you know what those are? Knives, forks. ¿Sí conocen estas palabras?
Yes,
Galileo,
ma'am.
You do. Somebody who yes. doesn't, I can show you a picture if you need.
Yes, ma'am.
You do. You're fine. Okay, so that's another word we use a lot. And then we have the word napkin. Napkin. Mayra, can you read it, please?
La What, teacher?
Napkin.
Napkin. Mm-hmm. A cloth or folder, piece of soft paper that you use to mop up split food in the UK people. 18 of would usually place a napkin on their lap to catch split food or drinks.
Okay, thank you, Mayra. So this is an, I think you can see it, right? This is a napkin, okay? Something, paper, paper that you use to clean your face. Or it could be fabric, clothes. You use to clean your face when you eat. We use napkin, Mayra? Mm-hmm. Do you understand? Yes, that's a napkin. Mm-hmm. It could be paper or it could be cloth. Sometimes we use something like cloth, right? A veces es como tela, no necesariamente papel. So it would be a napkin. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Mayra. Next word.
¿Cómo se dice esa? Esa donde dice in the... Está la U y está la K. ¿Cómo se dice?
UK. UK.
Así, UK.
Ajá, es United Kingdom. El país. Kingdom. Uh-huh. El Reino Unido. United Kingdom, pero le dicen UK.
Ok. Gracias, teacher.
You're welcome. Ok, starter. That's the next one. María Concepción, can you read it, please?
Started the first course of the meal, a small portion of food served either hot or cold. You might decide to skip this course if you are
not very hungry. Thank you, Maria Concepcion. I think you had some problems with the connection. Starter, what you ask or what you order in the restaurant when you get there, it could be nachos. Some people like to eat nachos, or maybe, what else do people ask for?
Soup, a little soup.
Uh-huh, soup, yeah, we call it consomme, right? Uh-huh. That could be considered a starter. I don't know if you like to ask for them, but sometimes when you wait for the main course, we ask for the starter.
Okay. Maybe appetizer?
Uh-huh, like appetizers. Correct, Manolo. Thank you. Do you have questions, more questions or comments in this moment about the vocabulary? No. Okay. Wendy, can you read the last one? Main course.
Okay. Main course. The main part of the meal, medium to large portions of food served.
Either.
Served either hot or cold. In the UK, main meals are usually served with vegetables.
Thank you, Wendy. Okay, so the main course is like the principal dish you ask for in the restaurant. It could be meat and rice, chicken, pasta, that is the principal dish you are looking for. Pizza, if that is what you wanted to eat. Okay, so here we have some words. Okay, remember booking, a party, menu, drinks menu, today's special, specials, cuddly, napkin, starter, and main course. Okay, some words. I can send it in the group. If you would like to have this document, I can send it to you there so you can save it. and you can use them later in the classes. Do you have questions? Questions for me? No? Bueno.
Hello.
No, okay. Ahí se los envío si ustedes desean. Ahí, ahí lo pueden guardar si ustedes quieren. Les aconsejo que traten de irlo memorizando porque ya verán que en las siguientes clases vamos a hacer role plays de restaurante donde van a ser meseros, managers, clientes y vamos a usar el vocabulary. Por eso los voy a empapar de mucho vocabulario day by day y sería bueno que lo empiecen ya a tratar de memorizar little by little. Okay, so let's continue. I'm going to share something by chat. Les voy a compartir un link para que vean un video. Just give me one moment. This video is about, it's called Fanboys. That is the name of the words that we are going to learn. Watch it 2 times and only the first 2 and 15 seconds of the video. Véanlo 2 veces, pero solo hasta el minuto 2:15, porque luego es un ejercicio y eso no lo vamos a hacer. Okay, 2 times. And pay attention to the words. ¿Quieren que lo mande a WhatsApp, Wendy? ¿O ahí
sí,
está bien? No. Okay.
No.
Okay, one moment.
Aquí no abro nada.
Ajá, sí, me acabo de acordar. Okay, Wendy, there it is.
Thank you.
Have you finished?
Finished.
Okay. And you guys?
No, yet.
Okay. Okay, let's continue. So now you have an idea about the words. I'm going to teach you how to use the fan voice. You have an idea with the video, but I'm going to tell you the way we can use the fan voice. Fan voice because they were using the first, the initial word. And all together we have that. It's like a way to memorize them. I sent a picture to the group where you have the fan voice, the meaning, and one example. Ahí en el grupo también les envié una picture donde están todas y les da el meaning, que es el que puse acá, y hay un ejemplo. Entonces vamos a aprender cómo utilizarlos. Okay, if you don't understand, please let me know. Okay, I can say, I like English because it is a different language, okay? This is one way to say it, but there is another option. You can use for because it has the same meaning. Yeah? For has the same meaning as because. You can say, I like English for, we use a comma, and then we use the fanboy. In this case, it's gonna be for, okay? For it is a different language. It's the same, but I'm using another option. Here I'm using the traditional word, the typical word because, but in option number two, I am using for. For means because, right? That's one. Or I could say another option. She needs to study English because she wants to live in the US. This is the normal way, but now you can use for. That's another option. You can say the same, but I'm going to change the connector, okay? I am going to use for, okay? That's the only change. She needs to study English for she wants. We'll use the comma. We use a comma and then we use the connector. For she wants to live in the US. Okay. I change the connector. Okay. Todas esas palabritas son connectors para unir dos oraciones or phrases. Okay. So there you can see the change. Questions about for? ¿Alguna duda sobre for?
Teacher, I have a question, but no es the fanboy, sino de el one que usted utilizó en la oración, donde dice, she needs to study English for she wants to live. El wants
cuando quiero, pero no solo cuando quiero algo de comer o algo de cariño, sino cuando es el verbo querer que nosotros tenemos en español.
Uh-huh. Yes. Yes,
por ejemplo, si yo digo quiero información, puedo utilizar el want.
Yes.
Want to. Uh-huh. Only one. Thank you, teacher.
And you're welcome. Other questions about for? The connector for? No. Okay, I think N is a
teacher.
Yes. Uh-huh. Elena? Yes.
When we decide use fanboys and cuando no?
It's optional. You have two options, but because it's more traditional, more common. However, or but, if you want to, you can use for, and that is also okay. So it's up to you. Usted decide, Elena. Because es el más tradicional, pero si usted lee cosas, libros en inglés, va a ver que for a veces va con este significado.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. And I think we don't have problems using and, right? Is the normal, okay? Like, I want to study and practice my English, okay? And is the normal connector you use to connect ideas, okay? No sé si tienen dudas con and. Yo veo que siempre lo han usado, and. It's okay, right? Vamos a saltar a nor, mejor ese. How to use nor. Here you have the meaning, and not, okay. Okay, nor can be sometimes complicated to use. We have a combination, neither nor. We have this common combination where we use neither or neither. You can say neither or neither. Both options are okay. We use them to introduce two negative elements. We use them to introduce two negative elements. I'm going to give you an example. Negative. I don't want. And now I have to introduce a negative element. Neither pizza nor, what is the meaning? And not, nor hamburgers. Okay. I don't want pizza, but I'm going to use neither. I don't want. Neither pizza nor hamburgers. None of the options. Or you can say, remember, it's negative. Neither my mom, and now another negative, nor my dad are going to the body. Okay. We use them to have two negative elements. Okay. Los vamos a utilizar para introducir en una oración dos elementos negativos. Okay. Van a usarlos en ese sentido. Así como en la segunda oración que ven acá, yo estoy negando, ¿verdad? Que alguno de ellos dos vaya a ir a esa party. Pero ponen primero neither para presentar su primer palabra negativa y luego nor para la segunda, ¿verdad? Para la segunda opción. Así como acá, neither y luego mencioné el primer elemento negativo, nor y luego mencioné el segundo elemento negativo. Another example. Ok. Siempre seguimos ese patrón. Primero con neither vamos a colocar el primero negativo. Neither you y luego va el otro, porque son una combinación. Nor my, neither you nor my mom, y luego ya lo normal. No anything about me. Do you understand? Si no entienden, está bien. Estos son un poco complicados. No sé si los comprenden o si tienen alguna duda. Galileo, you're fine.
Yes, ma'am, I understand.
Okay, that's excellent. ¿Hay alguien que tenga alguna pregunta sobre neither nor? No, okay. Ya los vamos a practicar, okay, but I will just finish. I will finish giving you the grammar. But, okay, ¿estamos bien con but? But is el normal but. But, fine. Or, are we okay with or? Yes? Okay. Yet. Bye. Entonces veamos yet and so. Yet and so. Yet. What does it mean? But is another option. Okay, like this. I want to study, but I am tired. That is the most common option, right? Option number two. I want to study, yet I am tired. The same meaning, but I am using a different word. Option, Galileo?
Sure. Mm-hmm. Is it exactly the same meaning?
The other option, it's like, aunque, that could be like the other meaning, but it's very similar to but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. I got it now.
Okay. Another option would be they need to go to the doctor, but they don't have money. Option number two. We will just change that word. They need to go to the doctor, comma, yet they don't have money. Okay. I only change the word. Okay, questions? Carlos, Jonathan, comments? No. Okay, the last one. So let's talk about so. What does it mean? That is why. Okay, imagine this. This is the situation. We have the situation. And on the other side, we are going to have the result or the effect. For example, let me see.
Teacher, después de tire dice, I want, ¿qué dice? Porque en mi pantalla solo dice inglés corporativo y no.
And now? Sorry.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, so imagine this. I am, this is the situation. I am tired. What is the effect? What is the effect? So, I am not going to go to work. Okay, I am tired. Or maybe I'm sick. Okay, to make it more real. I am very sick. I'm very sick. That is why I am not going to go to work. Okay, you have the situation, the problem, the situation, and you have the result. You are not going to work. Okay. She was angry. She was angry. So, or that is why. And then you mention the effect or the result. So, she hit the manager. Okay, that was the result. Okay, so you have the cause and the effect. Okay, now it is your turn. Okay, can you give me four. Make four sentences. I'm going to put it here. Make four sentences. The first one using for, number two using nor, number three using yet, and number four using so. Okay, make four sentences. Do you have questions for me? No sé si quieren preguntarme algo. No, no questions. Okay. Make four sentences and you can send them by chat, by WhatsApp, or you can say them. And then I will check them. And remember you have the picture in the group where you have all these options. And you have the meaning in one example too. Let me know if you need my help. Hi, Wendy. I just read the sentence. For, si no me equivoco, le está dando como el significado de para.
Yes.
Ah, ok. En este momento no es ese significado el que va a estar tomando. El ¿cuál? Significado que va a estar tomando es el de because.
¿Por qué tal cosa? Ah,
okay. Ajá. Así que maybe you can change it, Wendy, and send it again.
Okay.
Hi, Laura. Did you finish the sentence? ¿Ya completó esa oración? Number one. Yes. I don't hear you, Laura. Activate the microphone, Laura.
Separada la mandé. He hecho dos nada más por Jackie So.
Ok, entonces la de four. Le voy a dar feedback de esa, Laura. Lo mismo que le menciono a Wendy, el significado que le está dando ahí a su palabra es para también. En eso. Pero ahorita esa palabra for va a tomar otro significado. Significa because o porque, ¿verdad? Como lo tomaríamos en Spanish. Entonces, yes, Arnoldo.
Send my sentence in WhatsApp.
Ah, okay. I will check them in one second. Ajá. Entonces, Laura, ese, porque for puede tomar distintos significados, pero en este momento significa because. Solo que en vez de poner because, vamos a decir for. Try to change it. Try to change it, Laura, y la vemos. Ok, ven Arnoldo. Ok, thank you, Arnoldo. They are correct, maybe just some changes. Okay, number one, Arnoldo, I am tired for this day, was busy, in past tense. Number two, I don't like to climb. And here we have to use, I don't like, I don't like to climb, nor, oh, and we are missing neither to climb, nor to camp. Or camp. Quedaría así, number two, Armando. And then number three, is it in past tense, Arnoldo? Is the sentence in past tense? Or in present tense? Sentence number three and four.
Trato de saltar, pero estoy enfermo.
Ah, okay. So number three is correct. And number four, I think I watch sería como en past tense. Entonces solo hay que agregarle ed. Watch TV all night. So that is why I woke up late this morning. We just need to change the verbs to past tense.
In this moment. Mm-hmm. I changed in this moment.
Excellent. Okay.
I feel in this moment.
Okay, very good. How are you doing, guys? ¿Quiénes ya me terminaron para yo tenerlo en cuenta?
Me, teacher.
Jonathan. Ah, okay, Galileo. Arnoldo. Okay.
Me, teacher.
And Jonathan.
Teacher, yo voy a ser. Nada más ahí está en el chat la otra.
Okay, sí. Yo me voy a quedar revisando ahorita y los voy a enviar a una activity. Pero voy a darles un tiempo más a los que no han terminado. Ellie, I'm hungry, so I'm going to. Solo la M nos faltó ahí, Ellie.
Mm.
Yes. Uh-huh. Y Laura, I don't like neither tomatoes nor does he. Okay. Oh, okay. So, no, it's okay, Laura. Ya vi como la hizo. So, it's okay. Estamos bien ahí. I will take the attendance. I will take the attendance in this moment. And then we continue. Okay, so we start with Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Lilian.
Present.
Brian.
Carmona. Present.
Okay. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Jose Arnoldo.
Present, teacher.
Jose Galileo.
Present, ma'am.
Jose Jonathan.
Present.
Okay. Jose Rodrigo.
Present.
Juan Carlos. Laura Carolina.
Present.
Then María Concepción.
Present.
María Elena.
Present.
Mayra Moreno.
Present.
Okay. Nelson Cabarrete.
Present, miss.
Omar Francisco.
Present.
Okay. Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Then Zaira Marlene.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Wendy Maribel.
Present, teacher.
And Jenny Suleyma.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Thank you, Jenny. Okay, so I'm going to continue checking them and I will give you feedback. In this moment, you have to create a restaurant review. That is what we will be doing. It's a composition. I'm going to share something with you.
Miss.
Yes, Jonathan.
I have a question. El nor se puede usar como para decir esta persona no hizo esto y no tampoco hizo lo otro, como una doble negación.
Ajá. Okay. Yes. That's the way you will use it. Then, okay, this is what we will be doing. It's gonna be a review for your favorite restaurant. It's gonna be a group activity. While you work on this, I'm going to continue checking your sentences. If you haven't finished, you can send them after the class. Si no terminaron sus oraciones, me las mandan luego de la clase, ahí al grupo. Okay, pero me voy a quedar ahí revisándolas. Okay, so this is what you have to do. You have to write a 10-line review of your favorite restaurant. You have to answer the questions that you see here. You can use comparatives and the fan voice. Okay. Van a hacer un review, así como cuando Google les dicen que han visitado un lugar y que les dicen si quieren escribir un review. Entonces es como un review de los que salen en internet, que les dan información sobre ese restaurante. Eso es lo que ustedes estarían haciendo, ¿verdad? Una composition. Vamos a usar comparatives and the fan voice. Do you understand or do you have a question? Questions?
I don't understand, teacher.
Okay. Vamos a hacer un review, es como calificar un restaurante. Van a calificar un restaurante, Wendy. Usualmente esto se hace en línea.
¿Como una encuesta? No.
Es como, ajá, como una encuesta, como decir cómo estuvo el servicio de ese restaurante. Ajá, es como que usted escriba cómo califica a La Pampa y ya contestan las preguntas que están acá. What services do they offer? What characteristics make this restaurant so good? Y aquí dice que hay que usar comparatives y the fan voice, como una crítica para el restaurante. Okay, so if you don't have more questions, I'm going to create the groups. Once we finish this, you can send this by chat. Some of you will read it and then we continue with the role plays, the ones we couldn't finish yesterday. Okay, then. I will create the rooms. Okay, please accept the invite.
Teacher, yo tengo positivos ahora.
Ajá, Elena.
Y tengo dos dispositivos ahora y estoy en uno del traje.
Ok, escoja uno. ¿En cuál se va a meter?
En el 3.
En el 3. Vaya, entonces ya voy a... Así deje el otro, Elena. No lo mueva ni nada. Solo okay. Déjelo ahí.
talk about Hacienda Real.
Teacher. Sorry to interrupt. How can I help you?
Any problem?
Nos pasó lo mismo de ayer que no podemos compartir pantalla.
Okay, sorry.
A ver si nos desbloquea, por favor.
Mm-hmm. Yes, there it is. Any other questions you may have?
Thank you.
No, no more questions. No. Okay, no, all sure. Right.
Thank you.
See you in a moment. Thank you. Bye.
Hay que hacerlo bien para que Galileo no se enoje. La verdad, el servicio en Papayón es bastante bueno. A mí me gusta.
Es good. Uh-huh. Es bueno. Ok, entonces comenzamos.
Papayón.
Papayón.
La pizzería Papayón.
Es de los favoritos, lo vamos a poner acá.
Hi, Lily. Sorry to interrupt, guys. I read the sentences, ya leí las oraciones que envió. Sin embargo, estoy notando que los ha hecho con otra, como con otro significado, algunos. No los hemos colocado bien, así que le voy a explicar un poquito más en el otro room. Le voy a dar ahí ayuda, porque sí hay que cambiarlas. El okay. For que puso en la primera no va como because, sino que es como por el significado que está tomando. Y luego nor, la posición no iría ahí. También con yet iría en otro lugar. Y también so. Así que luego luego le voy a explicar más. Oscar en Nelson, no sé si lo enviaron ya ahí.
No lo he terminado. Solo en mi cuadernito lo he escrito. Yo se los envío.
Ok. It's okay. Luego lo envían. Trabajen ahorita en la composition solo. Okay. Y Jenny solo veo una. Okay. Entonces,
es que
luego.
Jennifer viene aún de camino.
Ah, Jenny todavía está. Ok.
Sí.
Y sí, tampoco creo que escuchó todo lo que hablamos de eso. No, vamos a dar ahí un review later. Ok. So, do you have questions for me before I go? Lily, no sé si se puede quedar usted el día de hoy para la session de 10 minutes. Vamos a hacerlo de esto. Le voy a explicar mejor estas palabritas.
Bye.
Okay. All right. See you later, guys. Bye. Hi, Laura and Brian.
Hi, teacher.
How are you doing? Do you need help?
Ay, todavía estamos pensando, teacher.
¿En qué parte?
En la redacción de la comparativo del restaurante, las carnes.
Son varias cositas.
Las opciones que tiene el restaurante, calificarlo, mejor dicho.
Sí, ajá, pero sí me entienden como a lo que me refiero, ¿verdad? Con el review es como una calificación que uno le da a un restaurante para que otra persona sepa, ¿verdad? Si lo recomiendan o no. Y ya ellos lo leen para ver qué tan bueno es el restaurante. Okay. Brian, did you send the sentences? No sé si envió las oraciones, Brian, porque no las veo. Todavía no las he terminado. Me hacen falta tres. Ok, me las envía luego a WhatsApp, entonces, y yo las reviso. Ok, so I will let you continue in that case. See you later.
See you later.
Bye.
Son 10.
Hi guys, how are you doing? Is there something I could help you with?
No, miss. For the moment, we are okay.
Okay, I'm going to stay here a moment, but you can continue, okay?
Okay.
And continue.
Okay. Sería una carta, menu, has. Tendría que ser el...
And podríamos utilizar with like a connector and one of most used words.
Aunque ahí en esa definición tiene algunos conectores, porque ahí le ha puesto el and.
Ajá.
And national framework.
Ajá.
Inclusion of international and national framework.
In addition to be.
To be.
Okay, sorry to interrupt. Anna and Mayra, did you send the sentences? I only see one sentence of yours, Mayra. Solo veo
yo no
las tenía
todavía, a mandar, se las iba y
ya. Ah, ok. Y Anna yo, las envió. ¿Verdad que no?
Sí, las he hecho, teacher, pero no, tampoco se las pude mandar.
Ah, ok. All right.
Pero solo no sé si están bien también, teacher.
Ok, entonces me las mandan después de la clase, porque ahorita todavía tenemos otras cosas.
Ajá. Sí, claro.
Sí, envíenmela al... Sí, las suyas sí ya las estuve revisando. Ah, no, no las terminé de revisar. Sí, ahorita las leo. It relaxes me. Solo la palabrita me faltó al final, Mayra. It relaxes me. Pero sí, era el significado correcto. Pero, ajá, Jonathan le dio el significado que era for. Ajá, neither my parents, yes. Esa estaba en la picture, si no me equivoco. Number two. Number two, neither my parents nor my friends supported me. So it's okay, that's correct. He says nice words, yet you don't trust him. Ajá, okay, that's correct. And my sister's one. Yes.
Estas conjunciones sustituyen ciertas palabras dentro de las oraciones.
Las reemplazan. Ajá. Yes. So, conectores, ¿verdad? Porque tenemos frases, a veces oraciones. Pero ajá, son como sinónimos, digamos, que podríamos llamarles. Algunos son sinónimos. Pero sí, good job, Jonathan. ¿Están bien? Solo la que le digo que estaba en la picture, pero las demás estaban. Excelente. Ok. ¿Y cómo van con este review? Ya casi lo terminan.
No falta poner los conectores.
Ok, just one more question. Ana, ¿con quién estaba trabajando el día de ayer? Que yo no pude copiar.
Con Oscar y con Laura.
Oscar, Laura. Ok. ¿And you, Mayra?
Con Ana Lilian y Concepción.
Lili y Concepción. Solamente. Ok. And Jonathan no estuvo acá, ¿verdad? Así que no le pregunto. Ok. Entonces hoy sí, los dejo. And I'll see you in one moment. Okay. Bye.
¿Qué sirve? ¿En la pizza de papayón sirve?
En la pizza de papayón. Aquí ver. Sería... ¿Cómo podemos hacer? Aquí papayón, ellos sirven mejores pizzas que en otras.
Hi guys, sorry to interrupt. Sorry que les quito ahí su pantalla, pero no puedo mostrar cosas de Google porque pueden cancelar el video porque se sube a YouTube, así que no vaya a ser, por eso lo quité. Ok, sorry. Nelson, ¿con quién me estaba trabajando usted ayer en el roleplay?
Con Jenny.
Ajá.
Con Jenny.
Just Jenny.
Sí.
Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, I'll let you continue. Si pueden, traten de no utilizar el translator, ¿verdad? Para que lo hagan con sus propias palabras y así practiquen más. Pero si lo necesitan usar, utilicen. Okay, para eso es mejor si no lo utilizan. Okay, all right. Okay. I'll let you continue. Bye.
Thank you.
Shrimp.
Teacher, hemos hecho un gran diálogo.
Excellent. Sí, son 10 líneas, así que pero iba a ser algo largo. Laura, who were you working with yesterday for the role play? Who were your partners?
¿Cómo dice, teacher?
¿Con quién trabajó el día de ayer en el role
play? Ah, con Beatriz y Oscar.
Ah, ok.
Hemos pasado, teacher, ya tenemos la presentación también.
Excelente. Ajá, ya la vamos a hacer. El Brian estaba ya para ese momento. Creo que ya no hubo un momento.
Con Laura.
No, ayer, yesterday.
Con Laura estaba.
Laura también.
Ayer también estaba con nosotros, Brian.
Ah, no, porque es la otra Laura. Entonces.
Hay otra Laura, teacher.
No, no que yo sepa.
Okay. Ah, Morena.
Porque ajá, tengo a Mayra.
No.
Pero, era no, para el roleplay del que van a dar luego de este.
Sí, es María, era, perdón.
María.
María Concepción.
Ah, María con José Rodrigo, me toca.
No, pero Mayra está trabajando con Concepción.
No, María. Bueno,
María. Okay.
María es. Y José Rodrigo.
María Elena.
Ella creo.
Ah, ok. Is there una something conocida. I could help you with before I go? Ajá. Do you
es
have
una
a question? Yes. Hoy sí, ya está acá. No sé si tienen alguna duda antes que me marche.
Espéreme, teacher. Yo, espéreme. Ay, ¿qué hice aquí? No sé cómo. Como que quiero presentarle lo que hemos hecho, teacher, y no puedo. Porque si no ve lo que no.
Puedo ver la pantalla.
Ah, la está bien.
Yes.
Y no sé cómo la he hecho minimizada, que no la veo.
Yes.
No,
yes,
nosotros Kat. Hemos hecho un tipo de inscripción, pero no sé si está bien. O está muy largo, no sé. Ay. Y acá cómo se expande, es que no puedo expandirla nuevamente, yo no la puedo ver, puede creer.
Ahí bórrele.
Ok, it's correct, solo que siento han utilizado, no sé, el translator, Google
sí,
Translate.
Teacher. Sí, teacher.
Sí, porque veo pero bastantes ya palabras complejas, como sword, o, ajá, y está bien, pero o sea, la idea, ¿verdad? De esta
actividad. Es de redactarlo uno, teacher.
Es que lo hagan ustedes con su propio conocimiento, ¿verdad?
Vamos a darle vuelta aquí a algunas palabras. Es que lo estamos resumiendo, teacher, ahorita. Ahorita entonces, solo es el párrafo completo.
Es como algo simple, ¿verdad? Como que decir, I like this restaurant.
Porque me gustan.
Ajá, y hacerlo.
Pero mire, teacher, lo que no entendí es. Como dice usted que las, ¿cómo se llama? Ah, no, pero no vamos a usar el more beautiful porque no estamos comparando con otro. O me gustan estas carnes porque, o me gusta este restaurante por tal cosa.
Podrían para utilizar los comparativos. Ajá, como
siempre vamos a comparar con X restaurante.
Por con decir. Uno, ah, ajá. Okay. Para poder introducir los comparativos que hay que usar también.
Ok, teacher, vamos a delimitar aquí.
Una podría sección. Ser como better, ¿verdad? Mejores precios, better prices than other restaurants. Está comparando este con otro restaurante, pero como un grupo de restaurantes. Ya sería como dos.
Ok.
Ajá. Other restaurants in El Salvador. Ok.
Ya vamos a agregar esa parte, teacher.
Yes, los, it's okay.
Comparativo.
I'll let you continue.
Okay,
okay, see gracias. You.
See you later.
¿Eso puedo poner? Accesible. ¿Cómo se dice?
Accessible.
Accessible.
How are you doing?
Normal.
How you finish?
Accessible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Como 6 líneas.
Okay. Wendy, who were you working with yesterday for the role play? ¿Con quién trabajó? Para el
roleplay. Para el roleplay fue con Eli y con Juan Carlos, creo que se llamaba el otro muchacho.
Juan Carlos is not here. Ok.
Podemos hacerlo entre Eli y.
Ah, ok, excelente. ¿Y tú, Omar? ¿Con quién me trabajó ayer, Omar?
Con José Mazariego y quiero ver. Ay, Juan Carlos, no me acuerdo cómo se llama, pero no. El de Cotecna.
José Arnoldo.
José Arnoldo.
Sí. Ajá.
Pero estaba el otro que es. No me recuerdo lo mismo. Sé que trabaja en el de en Cotecna.
I don't know who works there. Bueno, ya vamos a preguntar. Zaira was not here, así que. Okay. Do you need
I was help? Not in class.
Yo sé, I know.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Miss,
do you need help?
Score, compré de restaurante. Nosotros estamos, o lo que hemos comprendido es que queremos comparar lo de la pampa y el lomo de la aguja. Entonces,
con otro restaurante.
Ajá, lo que queremos es como que comparar precios y calidad, podríamos decir, bajo nuestro juicio, bajo nuestro score.
If you compare, those two restaurants, it's yes. Gonna be okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Other questions, Zaira or Wendy?
No.
No.
No, teacher.
Okay.
Por el momento no.
All right, you can continue. I'm just going to check your sentences here. Omar, did you send them? Envió sus oraciones, Omar, in the chat.
No.
No, no, ¿verdad? Porque no las he visto.
Me falta uno.
Ok, las enviamos después al grupo cuando ya terminemos. That's fine. Then Zaira.
Only one about English is
correct. Veo que hizo el change, ¿verdad? De because y luego lo transformó. Ajá. Yes.
Lo tomé del ejemplo, teacher.
Ajá. It's correct. It was correct.
Mando luego las otras al chat.
Please.
Yes, Omar. It's correct. It's correct. I am overweight for enjoy running. It's number one. Four.
The second. Me la envía mejor para leerla bien.
Okay.
Por la última parte no estoy segura si está bien o no. But I will read it.
Running. Sí, como correr.
Porque no corre.
Uy.
Y como tengo sobrepeso, por eso voy a ir a correr.
Pero por eso ya sería diferente a because.
Hoy no le das caso.
Sería otro. Porque.
Peleando con mi perrito.
Utilizando.
Ya lo escuché.
Because. Eso es lo que debo utilizar en este caso.
Tendría que ser con ese significado de because.
Ok.
Uh-huh, así que.
Thank you, Miss.
Uh-huh. Then Wendy. Wendy, la de yet. We have to change it. The one about I am happy, so I'm healthy. Yes, that will be correct. Solo la de yet. Vamos a verlo después. Okay. Guys, vamos a tener que cerrar los rooms in about 1 minute. Y leemos, ok, lo que tienen. Okay, see you there in one moment. Welcome back. I hope you could finish. Okay, so let's begin with Carlos. Carlos, Galileo, and Elena. Okay, can you read your review, please?
Okay.
Teacher, may I share my screen?
Yes, go ahead.
Usted solo pasa viendo la gente.
Okay, Carlos, please read it.
Number one, the Hacienda Real offers different food menu, yet it is really expensive. They have an exquisite dressed light caramel cheese, for example, for they have a great chef. Indeed, attention is better than other restaurants. It is a quiet place, and they have a more beautiful garden than other restaurants. Maria, continues, please.
Yes. I don't want to hear neither band music nor cumbia music that people play. En la Hacienda Real, garden is lighter at night, so it is beautiful. In Hacienda Real, have a special menu program that others don't have. Also, I like to go to this restaurant. Yes, I don't have enough money. The environment is really comfort, so I need to come back again.
Thank you. Uh-huh. And you were preparing number 10, right? Okay, thank you. Thank you for your effort. Very good sentences. You use different conjunctions and comparatives. Maybe the only comment I will give you is about the composition. It had to be a little bit more natural, like in the form of a paragraph, but we will be working on that in the next classes. So thank you. Thank you, Carlos, Galileo, and Elena. Okay, now let's listen to another group, Rodrigo and Maria Concepcion.
Okay, lo leería, teacher, porque no le escribimos en la...
Yes, okay.
Is the Thomas Roma's restaurant, especially rib and sauce, onion rings, potato chips, delicious food, customer service. The restaurant is bigger than the competition. It has a nice atmosphere than other. Its seats are comfortable than other restaurants. Only teacher.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I love Tony Roma's too. I like that restaurant. Okay, yes. Thank you, Rodrigo. Maybe you can send me the composition by WhatsApp later.
Okay.
And okay. I will read it.
Okay.
Okay. And then can you continue? Let me check over here. Anna, Jonathan, Mayra, and Nelson. I don't remember if you were in this team, Nelson.
Okay, Chloe Canela. Chloe Canela, specialist a la carte menu. He has breakfast and today special and seasonal menu. Has been created for a fusion of international and national flavor. In addition to being constant innovation to offer you exquisite dishes prepared with fresh ingredients, so are also part of the Mediterranean gastronomy. Beatriz?
Okay. You will find a variety of meats, seafood, sandwiches, pizza, and more. You will be surprising, but it's a tasty and also it's a front of affordable, ¿cómo se pronuncia, teacher, eso?
Affordable.
Affordable price and delivery.
Okay, thank you. Thank you guys for your composition. I like that you did it in that way, in the form of a paragraph. Maybe we needed more comparatives, maybe more comparatives and fanboys, other phrases. Okay, but we will continue working on that, okay, in the next days. Okay, we will listen to one more composition, one more review, and then we start talking about the role plays. Okay, can you please continue, Lily, Nelson? Nelson, I don't remember if you were in this group or in the other group. Jenny, oh yes, you were here, right? And Oscar.
Okay, don Oscar, ahí lo tiene.
Lea, don Nelson.
Okay. If Pizza Papa John serves the more delicious pizzas than the other pizzeria in the country, did you say fresh and important ingredients for the best quality? When you visit the restaurant, they attend faster than the offered place. The delivery service is better, but the cost of the pizza is very, very high. And that's not, I have many promotion, nor I have more restaurant.
Thank you guys. I like your composition as well. And thank you for trying. I know that it's a little bit difficult sometimes to find the right words and to use all the grammar. It's difficult, but you're getting better. Okay, so congratulations. And remember, don't give up. Okay, continue little by little, we're going to get better. So now we continue with the role plays. Okay, we will continue with the role plays. Jonathan and Zaira will stay with me over here. Jonathan and Zaira se van a quedar acá conmigo. Y los demás van a. How much time do you need? Is it 5 minutes? Okay, creen que con 5 minutos terminan lo que les falta, guys? Porque no sé cómo quedaron ayer. Okay. Bueno, cualquier cosa, let me know. Okay, one moment. Okay, so I'm going to check. Ana Beatriz, you were working with Oscar and Laura, correct?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Then we will have Jenny and Nelson. Next. Lily, María Concepción, and Mayra. Next, Rodrigo, Elena, Brian. ¿Sí está bien ese team? Rodrigo, Elena, Brian.
Yes, teacher.
Ah, okay.
Yes, teacher.
Elena and Brian. Okay. Next. Omar, Arnoldo, está por acá Arnoldo, no lo veo. Se le fue quizás su conexión. Bueno, ok. Then, Galileo.
Carlos Antonio Escobar, Miss.
Ah, en Carlos. Ok.
Yes.
So, ok, Omar, en Carlos. Arnoldo is not here. I don't know if you can send him a message to see what happened. Okay, then Galileo, who were you working with yesterday?
I lost my connection yesterday.
Ah, so okay.
I didn't finish the class.
Okay. Okay, Wendy and you, who were you working with?
With Ellie and Juan Carlos.
Ellie is not here in this moment. Ellie? Y Juan Carlos tampoco.
No. ¿Mm? Alone.
Okay. Vamos a posponerlo entonces, el suyo. Please open their rooms. Los que sí están, open their rooms. And the ones, the other ones stay here with me. Okay, yes. I think all of you are here, right? Sorry, Galileo, I sent you there by mistake. That is why I brought you back. Okay, we will wait a moment for your classmates to come back. If you would like to, if you have a question, I can answer your questions. If not, I can assign you something to work on while we wait. No sé si necesitan ayuda con algo, si no les asigno algo, ¿verdad? Para hacer in the meantime. Wendy sí le quería dar feedback de unas cositas ahí.
Sí, so,
vamos a hacer un pequeño review. Ok, Wendy, hablemos de for y luego vamos a hablar de yet. Ok, so for puede significar diferentes, ok, diferentes cosas, depende del contexto. Ahorita lo estamos viendo con este significado. Because. So you can say, ok, why do you work? Why do you work, Wendy? Why do you work? ¿Cómo respondería esa pregunta?
Why
do you?
Because I like my work and I need the money.
Okay, so this is the traditional way to say it. Esa sería su manera tradicional de decirlo, ¿verdad? Pero ahora, lo único que usted tiene que hacer es cambiar la palabra.
Oh.
I work for, I like my job. Entonces, ese es el significado ahorita de for. Because. And yet,
Jonathan, Galileo? your microphone, Jonathan.
I think it's Wendy. Okay, so that is the way it works, Wendy. For the other option we have is okay. Yet, what is the meaning of yet, Zaira? In this moment, what does it mean? Do you remember the meaning of yet? I don't hear you, Zaira.
But, teacher?
But.
Uh-huh. So you have to use it in that way. Entonces tiene que utilizarlo, Wendy, ya en ese sentido. Su oración creo que la había iniciado con yet. O lo puso en otro contexto. Okay. I try, in past tense, I try to study, but I couldn't. I try to study, but I couldn't.
La clase no yet start.
¿Mm?
Todavía lo había puesto.
Ajá, con otro significado. Correcto. O sea, está bien, it's okay, pero el contexto me indica que usted lo usa en otra manera. Y yo el significado que quiero es ahorita, but. Entonces ya sería, I try to study. Yet, I couldn't. So just be careful, ¿verdad? Just tengan cuidado de cuál es el contexto. Y ya media vez ya saben el contexto, ya se utiliza de esa manera. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to give you that feedback.
Okay.
Now your classmates are coming back. They have some role plays to give. So we will listen to them. Could you finish?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, excellent.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there a volunteer? Is there someone who would like to start?
Me, teacher. Solo que necesitamos una ayuda. Necesitamos de su ayuda para que usted interprete ahí el faltante.
Okay. What do I have to do?
Okay. Ahorita comparto, teacher. Teacher, you are Arnoldo.
Ah, okay. Okay, I think it's a little bit difficult for me to read. Can you change the color of the font?
Okay.
Uh-huh. Es que el color me...
Sí, yes.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning, gentlemen. How can I help you?
Thanks. We are looking for a new place for the holiday party. Omar.
Sorry. What kind of place do you offer to use?
We need some options. What do you prefer?
I think two options, the beach and the mount.
The beach is hotter than mount.
Yes, but the mount is more comfortable than beach.
How many people are attending this party?
25 people.
In this case, the mountain is better than the beach.
Absolutely. Cold is better than hot.
What kind of food do you offer to us?
I like Mexican food.
The Salvadorian food is better than Mexican food. I like the pupusas or typical food.
Okay. All right.
Only that.
Thank you. Thank you, Carlos and Omar. Yes, I don't know. Maybe Arnoldo lost the connection because he was here. So probably something like that happened. Where it says mount, were you talking about the mountains? Were that the word? Was that the word that you were using, mountain? Carlos and
mountain.
Uh-huh.
Mountain.
Yes. Was that the word? Because in the presentation it said mount.
Okay.
Like
mountain.
Like Mount Everest, but that is something different. In mountains, it's like Apaneca, right? Ataco. Mountains. Ah, okay. And the other point, people just like that, that is the plural form. Okay, uh-huh. Without yes.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Nelson and Jenny, can you continue, please?
Hello. Okay. Hola, Jenny. Okay, listo.
Hi. Yes.
Bueno, okay, yes. Hi, Jenny. Can you recommend a place for my graduation party?
Sure. I know the Cameron in Terminales de Santa Teresa for your celebration.
Ah, which is better?
The Cameron's room is bigger than Terminales de Santa Teresa's room. The Cameron's scenery is more beautiful than Terminales de Santa Teresa, Termales de Santa Teresa. But Termales de Santa Teresa's food is more delicious than the Cameron.
Okay, what is a place?
Termales de Santa Teresa price is lower than the Cameron's price.
Ah, thank you, Jenny. I didn't eat sesame termales de Santa Teresa because my budget is alone.
It's thanks, a pleasure. Jenny. It's a pleasure to help you, Nelson.
Okay, thank you, Jenny, for the information.
Okay, excellent. Uh-huh, good job. Thank you, Nelson and Jenny. A lot of comparatives. You try to use them a lot, so that's good. Okay, now, can you continue, Anna? Anna yes, and Oscar.
Good morning. We need a budget to celebrate the Christmas party of our world teams.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to serve you. My name is Oscar.
We are looking for a room with capacity for 100 people.
Also, that the event room is perfectly equipped and will an excellent professional service.
Our hotel in San Salvador has 4 modular rooms event, totaling 60 square meters, thus being able to host conventions, conferences, business lunches, and dinner. Cocktail and coffee break with maximum 300 attendees.
No sé por qué no se me mira lo de arriba. Beyond decoration, that's the contemporary one. Laura.
And that the atmosphere is more cheerful than boring.
I offer you in our royal room or suite room, which includes buffet, diner, and unlimited soda with live music for 32 per person.
It's cool. Live music is better. That's mobile disco.
Comparing the price, it is cheaper than the hotel we went to last year.
Also, I can include coffee and water for a price of $5.
Oscar, but the royal room is bigger than the suite room?
Yes, only 10 square meters, bigger than the suite room.
Okay, Oscar, thank you for information.
You send me a detailed budget to the email laura.vigil. Poi, @atlantida.com.
Okay, I will be a pleasure to serve you.
Thank you.
Thank you for teaching placement.
Thank you. What a beautiful presentation. I like the pictures. Did you do it, Anna, the presentation? Or who did it?
Yes.
Uh-huh. You are good. You have very good creativity to create presentations, Anna. Yes, it looks good. So thank you very much. Maybe I will help you just with 2 words. Atmosphere. That is the correct pronunciation of that word. Atmosphere.
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 Atmosphere. Fire.
Fear.
Atmosphere.
Yes, there you go. Anna, can you repeat?
Atmosphere.
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 Fear. With F. It sounds like
fears.
F. Fear. Yes.
All right.
Okay. Thank you. And arroba in English is at Laura, at gmail.com.
Repeat, teacher.
Arroba, at, in English.
At.
Ajá, that is the correct way.
Okay.
Y el punto, recordemos que sería that. En este caso, that.
No,
point is about math, mathematics. Ahí sí es point. Okay. Y period es cuando hablamos de gramática. So it has different names para hacernos la vida más complicado in English. Okay, thank you, Laura, and you guys. We have Brian, Rodrigo, and Elena. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay.
Hi, Brian. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Maria. Nice to greet you.
Do you remember that we were appointed by manager to organize the company's Christmas party?
You're right. Nancy gave me the number of a person who is dedicated to that and can help us. Do you think if we talk to him?
I would be excellent. Let's see what you suggest. Ring.
Good afternoon. My name is Jose Rodrigo, organizer of the event and party in which I can serve you.
Nice to meet you. My name is Brian, my partner Maria, and are in a Chinese organization. The company's Christmas party, and we need your help.
It will be a pleasure. Do you have something special or a party theme, or is you like your event to be in the month, on the beach, or in a restaurant?
We have thought of two options. You will have information on packets in Bahia del Sol or Estarimar, and we want to compare with a restaurant option within Los Cebollines.
It will be a pleasure if you share your emails with me. I send you update information.
Brian GT9 at gmail.com. And then Mariela, Maria Elena.
At
gmail.com. Mm-hmm. Is that of my college? That is, she shares all the information of her consultants, please.
I share in with your in moment. Happy afternoon.
A moment later, I have already sent information so that we compare the and decide. We will review it, Jose.
It's fine.
The beach package in Bahia del Sol is cheaper than the Estarimar.
Yes, you're right. Bahia Cerro Imara has more service than Bahia del Sol.
Another thing to access is that Bahia del Sol beach is more rocky than Estarimar beach.
What is the term of distance? Estarimar and closer than Bahia del Sol?
And not forget that comparing with the Cebollines package is cheaper than the beach hotels.
If several distance, also Los Cebollines are closer than beach hotel.
If we reserve in advance and Los Cebollines offer us a closet party only for us, office with more service than beach hotels.
Well, let's decide. It will be a Los Cebollines the party of a girl.
Eso es en otra conversación. Thank you.
Okay, good job. I like the imagination, like one moment later, the sound of the, I think it was like the bell ring, right? So it was very good and a very long conversation. So thank you, okay? Thank you for your effort. Then we have Lily, Maria Concepcion, and Mayra, but can we do it tomorrow because of the time? So Lily, Maria Concepcion, and Mayra, tomorrow we will listen to your role play and I will give you some feedback, everyone. I will give you feedback about comparatives. Okay, do you have any questions before I take the attendance? No, no questions. Okay, so I'm going to take the attendance then. Hold on. Okay, so let's start with Ana Beatriz.
Present, teacher.
Ana Lilian.
Present.
Brian Javier.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Antonio.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth. Jose Arnoldo. Jose Galileo.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Jose Jonathan.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Carlos. Laura Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay. María Concepción.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Elena.
Present, teacher. I'm here.
Mayra Moreno.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Nelson Gabacete.
Present, miss.
Thank you. Omar Francisco.
Present.
Oscar Arnulfo.
Present.
Zaira Marleni.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Wendy Zabaleta.
Present, teacher.
Okay. And Jenny Santos.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. So remember to send me the sentences. Okay, tomorrow, if you're tired, send them to me and I will check them. Have a good night. Sweet dreams. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye,
teacher.
Bye. Good night. Bye.
Tomorrow.
Good night. Blessings.
Good night.
Bye.
Thank you.
See you, teacher.
See you, Maria Concepcion. Okay, one moment, Lily. Okay, Lily, would you like to check? Would you like to check what I told you about the connectors, or is there something else? No sé si quisiera que viéramos lo de los conectores, o no sé si tiene otra cosa en mente.
Pues eso, pero también en lo de ayer, cómo estaba relacionado con la primera tarea, no la pude hacer.
¿Qué pasó?
Pero no sé, le agrego lo como usted dijo, pero sale incorrecto. Pero por ahorita, si gusta, explíqueme lo de la...
Bye. Veamos eso y luego veo lo que pasó. Bye. Comencemos con for. Bye. Dijimos que for toma el significado de because, right? Entonces lo vamos a utilizar usualmente en medio de nuestras oraciones, ¿verdad? Como que si yo diga, I work because I need the money. Okay. Entonces, si usted ve el conector en medio, en la mayoría de sus oraciones, usted me lo estaba poniendo al principio.
Al principio.
Ajá. Pero antes de eso, necesitamos algo, porque estos son conectores. Y no había algo que estaba conectando, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
Entonces, aquí ya podríamos sustituirlo, ¿verdad? I work because... I'm sorry. Aquí vamos a utilizar el otro. For... I need the money. Okay. Entonces ahí está tomando el mismo, ¿verdad? El mismo significado que because, solo que estoy utilizando for. ¿Verdad?
Pero puedo poner for o puedo poner because.
Puede poner cualquiera de los dos.
Ah,
Usualmente el más común es el de because, pero hay otros, está este for, también está since, ¿verdad? Hay diferentes palabras que significan because, pero el más común, ¿verdad? Ahorita que vamos comenzando es ese de because, pero hay otros.
Okay,
entonces eso es sobre ese. De ahí, yet, ¿se recuerda qué significaba? Yet.
Yet era igual a but.
Ajá, era igual a but. Entonces lo usa en el mismo sentido que but, solo que va a usar yet, ahora, ¿verdad? Como que diga, I have to study, but I don't have time. Okay, entonces ahí está, ¿verdad? El but. Lo único que yo voy a hacer es que hoy voy a usar un sinónimo de but. Voy a usar yet. I have to study. Yet. I don't have time. Entonces, si usted vuelve a analizar la posición, no los he puesto al principio, ¿verdad? Al principio de la oración. Sino que está conectándome, porque es un conector, entonces me conecta la primera oración con la segunda. De ahí el otro, ¿verdad? Este, neither. Este ya de por sí es un poco complicado, neither con nor. Quizás es como cuando usted dice, mire, yo no quiero esto ni lo otro. Algo así es como lo que estamos diciendo, como ni no. Como no quiero esto ni lo otro. Entonces, usualmente van acompañados y juegan el papel juntos. Usualmente va a poner algo negativo, como que diga, I don't need, well, algo así, perdón. I don't need neither your help nor your money as an example. Entonces, de nuevo, la posición no podría ser utilizada al principio, pero lleva otra como estructura, por decirlo así. Entonces aquí es como que uno diga, mire,
yo... ¿Prueban las dos?
No siempre, pero ahorita es, en esta manera, digamos.
En algunas oraciones, sí.
Ajá, en algunas oraciones, sí. Entonces esto es como algo que quiere decir que es negativo, ¿verdad? Y el nor solo va a agregar otra cosa negativa. Porque significa eso, en not, ¿verdad? Es como que yo le diga, mire, yo no quiero ni su ayuda, ni su tiempo, ni su dinero, sorry. Algo así es lo que estamos como dando a entender cuando usamos estos dos. Ni esto, ni lo otro. Y lo usamos con eso, con dos, usualmente, ¿verdad? Entonces, ese iba ahí. Y el otro era so, ¿verdad? So, que significa that is why. Tampoco lo vamos a poner al principio, Lily, sino que va a ir en medio. Porque recuerde de que va a tener un como, por decirlo así, una causa y un efecto. Como que diga, I am tired. ¿Y cuál es la consecuencia o el resultado? Entonces ya digo yo, por eso, so, I'm going to take a nap. Como estoy cansada, ¿verdad? Y va a haber un efecto. Voy a tomar una siesta. Entonces, en todas las oraciones que le doy, solo me están conectando ideas. Una y la otra. Para decirlo. Entonces, eso es lo que yo había... Noté, pero estaba algo largo para explicárselo.
Sí. Es que me cuesta, teacher.
No, pero no se rinda, como le digo. Mire, continúe, cuesta, pero se puede. Se puede, solo que requiere, ¿verdad?
Sí, tiempo porque y... sí tengo así dificultad para armar oraciones, para sí. entenderlas o incluso para entender cuando me está diciendo algo. Son pocas las cosas que logro.
Ah, cuando lo digo en inglés.
Ajá.
Ah, ok. Sí, por eso a veces también lo digo en español por cualquier cosa. Pero sí, mire, sí. cuando usted no entienda algo, dígamelo. Mándeme un mensaje privado, ¿verdad? Porque yo sé que a veces cuando todos dicen que sí, uno se siente raro decir que no entendió.
Sí.
Entonces puede mandarme un mensaje privado, ¿verdad? Y yo puedo hacerlo de manera general. Porque puede que no solo sea usted, sino que también haya alguien más, ¿verdad? Entonces, pues dígame, yo le ayudo. Y con respecto a la tarea, pues la estoy viendo acá. La estoy viendo aquí, la tarea.
Vaya,
¿qué errores?
Ajá. La puse. No es el error, sino que creo que yo no la puedo estructurar. La... Ya le digo dónde es. Ahí en ese yo le puse my house is y como estábamos viendo que se le agregaba, ¿verdad? Otra así. Ajá.
Pero
así lo he agregado y siempre me sale incorrecto.
Ahí me manda una captura entonces porque sí estaría bien así.
Sí, porque la
pero tengo. Hay que ponerle el punto, hay que usar la mayúscula, Lili, porque a veces hasta eso va el programa, que tiene que ponerlo sí. justo, ¿verdad? Usando todo.
Ah, sí me falta entonces, porque solo puse my house is bigger, ¿cómo se lee?
Bigger,
your, y al punto.
Ah, ok. Hay que agregarle el then. Y la segunda ya sería, como ya tiene más de dos sílabas, ya sería more beautiful. Y siempre
sí, then. A la segunda sí, me sale incorrecta siempre agregándole el Peter Stone.
Ajá, quedaría así.
Pero entonces no se pone toda la oración, solamente lo que la complementa.
Todo, pero yo aquí solo le estoy diciendo cómo quedaría esa parte.
Porque ahorita la puse toda.
Ajá.
Vale que no está correcto.
Ahí me manda entonces una captura y yo voy a ver qué pasó. Pero sí quedaría... This red flower is
a la otra no le agregaría then.
¿A cuál
otra? Yo le puse this red flower is more beautiful than the yellow one.
Yes, ajá, así es.
No sé por qué dicen incorrectas entonces. Ahí le voy a mandar entonces
sí,
la captura.
Mándemela, ajá. El otro quedaría.
No.
This book is more interesting, quedaría. Than the movie. Y esta quedaría. Non-smokers usually live longer than smokers. Smokers. Y luego la última, Holiday by the Sea, is, esta cambia la palabra, better than.
¿Y por qué se cambia eso?
Ah, es una excepción a la regla, se le llama. Hay algunas palabras que su comparativo es diferente, que no solo lleva la E y la R, como good es uno de ellos. Ha escuchado la palabra better, ¿verdad? Como
sí.
She's better. Entonces, es porque en el inglés es una excepción y dice, para este lo vamos a cambiar. Entonces se usa better. Pero si está usando eso, Lili, y le da error, envíemelo porque sí lo está poniendo como debería de ser.
Ok. Uh-huh.
Ok, Lili. We will finish here. You're welcome. Espero que le haya ayudado ahí un poquito más sí, explicación. La verdad, sí.
Estaba toda confundida.
Y si no, pues ahí está también el video y lo puede ver otra vez. Y de ahí vamos a ver el viernes, si no me equivoco, volvemos a hacer un review para practicar eso. Si puede, si le queda tiempo, porque yo sé que están ocupados también trabajando, ¿verdad? Vuélvalas a hacer y me las envía para ver qué tal les salen, ¿verdad? Las horas. Bye. Okay, bye. Have a good night. See you good tomorrow. Night. Bye bye.